Welcome to tutorialsinhand.com. In this video tutorial, we are going to see how we can write multiplication table in Java using for loop. To be more specific, we will be using nested for loop. That is one for loop within another for loop. So let's see how we can write that. Now we want to print the multiplication table starting from 1. So outer for loop will be starting from 1 and then it will go on till where you want to print the multiplication table. If you want to print till 20, then you should give the condition as I less than is equals to 20, but here I want to print only till 10, so my condition will be I less than is equals to 10. So this will start from 1. It will print the multiplication table of 1 in the first iteration, and then in the next iteration it will print the multiplication table of 2, in the next it will print for 3, and so on till 10. And for that we need to increase the value of I by 1 after each iteration, right? So this is outer for loop, which will stand still during each iteration till the inner for loop iterates for 10 times for the same value of I. That is, in the first iteration the value of I will be 1, and once it enters the inner for loop, then the value of I remains 1 for the value of this inner for loop till it loops for 10 times. So here we will have int j is equals to 0 and j less than is equals to 10. So what is happening? We will be printing 1 into 0, then 1 into 1, then 1 into 2, then 1 into 3 till 1 into 10, because we are giving the condition as j less than is equals to 10. So we will print till 1 into 10 is equals to 10, right? If you want to print till 20, that is 1 into 20 is equals to 20, then you should increase the condition, this one, accordingly. Increase the value as per your requirement. We will be printing from 1 into 1 to 1 into 10. So we are giving the condition as j less than is equals to 10, and then we will increase the value of j by 1 during each iteration. So this is the logic that is going to give you the multiplication table starting from 1 till 10, and for that we will show you how we can do that. Let's see this diagram. This is the two loops that we have written, right? Here we have I less than 21, but because we wanted to print the table till 20, but here in our case we want to print it till 10, right? So we have got I less than is equals to 10. For more appropriate thing, it will go on till 10, right? So I less than is equals to 10. In that case, what is happening is, as we stated, that this I will be 1 during the first iteration. The value of I will be 1 during the first iteration, because we are starting from I is equals to 1. It will check the condition whether 1 less than is equals to 10 or not, and it will be true. Then we increase the value of I by 1 for the next iteration. In this iteration, the value of I will be 1. So we enter the inner for loop. Now remember, the value of I is 1, right? And now this value of j from 0 to j less than is equals to 10 will keep on iterating for this value of I is equals to 1 10 times, and we are going to get something like this, where this is the value of I which remains 1 till j has looped for 10 times, right? So this is the value of j, which is iterating for 10 times, and once it complete iterating for 10 times, then the inner for loop ends, because j's value will become 11, and once it becomes 11, 11 less than is equals to 10 will hold false, and once it holds false, this inner for loop ends. And once it ends, we again come back to the outer for loop, and this time the value of I will increase from 1 to 2, and then again we are getting something like this, where value of I has now increased to 2, and now 2 less than is equals to 10 will be true, and we will increase the value of 2 to 3 for the next iteration. And once we enter this loop during this iteration, the value of I remains 2 till this j, that means inner for loop, again iterate for 10 times, and once it iterates for 10 times, we will get something like this: 2 into 0, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. This is the value of I and j as per the iteration during each iteration, right? So we are going to make use of this value to print the multiplication table. How? we are having a simple print statement where we will print the value of I first so that it remains 1 every time. Then this is the string into we are printing so that it places multiplication after each value of I, and then we are printing the value of j. That means value of j during each iteration will increase from 0 to 1, 2, 3 and so on till 10. So this is how we get I into j. That means this is how we will get 1 into 0, 1 into 1, 1 into 2 till 1 into 10 each time. And once this is available to us, then what we are doing is we are again giving one string is equals to, which will be placed after the value of I into j once it is printed, then is equals to will be placed during each iteration after this, and then we are calculating the value by multiplying I with j. That means we are here multiplying 1 with 0. So 1 into 0 becomes 0. So this is how we get 1 into 0 is equals to 0. So let's check once again how we are getting it. Value of I is 1 for the first iteration. When we enter within the inner for loop, what is happening is j is equals to 0. So j less than is equals to 10. So 0 less than is equals to 10 is true. We increase the value of j by 1 for the next iteration. And then what is happening is this I is having the value 1 and this j is having the value 0. So this is what we are getting during the first iteration, that is value of I is 1, j is 0, and we are multiplying I into j. So that gives us this 0. Now this for loop first iteration ends, we move again to this inner for loop, and then we are having the value of j as 1 during the second iteration. So 1 less than is equals to 10 will be true, and we will increase the value of 1 to 2 for the next iteration, and we will enter within this inner for loop. Now the value of I again remains 1, but this time the value of j has increased by 1 to 1, and that is what is getting placed at this place. This value of I as 1 is printed here, this into is placed here, then we are having the value of j as 1 which is placed here, then we are having is equals to which is again placed here, and now we are calculating the value of I into j. That means 1 into 1 is calculated, and this is the product that we get. Again inner for loop ends, and we again come to the beginning of this for loop, and now the value of j is 2 in the third iteration. Again 2 less than is equals to 10 will be true, and we increase the value of 2 to 3 for the next iteration. Now we again come inside this. Now this value of I is again 1. We place this multiplication sign at this place, and now the value of j is 2 which is getting placed here, and now is equals to is also placed after 2, and then we are calculating the value I into j. That means 1 into 2 is getting calculated, and the product is printed at this place, and this will keep on till j becomes is equals to 10. And once it becomes is equals to 10, we will again have the value of I as 1 and j as 10, and in between this multiplication sign will be placed. So we get this one, and then is equals to is placed, and we calculate the value I into j. That means 1 into 10, and we get this value 1 into 10 is equals to 10. And now what happens is j becomes 11, and once it becomes 11, then 11 less than is equals to 10 will turn out to be false, and once it turns out to be false, we come out of the inner for loop and again come to the outer for loop, and now the value of I will increment to 2, right? The value of I will increment to 2, and now we will print the multiplication table of 2 in the same fashion as we have printed for 1. Only the thing is this time 2 will remain constant till this j will loop for 10 times from 0 to 10, sorry 11 times from 0 to 10, and we will get the values, or we will place the values of I and j, and then we will place the value of product in the respective position to get get the multiplication table. Now you can use the same logic to understand how it will print from 1 to 10. So the value of I will keep on increasing after each time j has completed its 10 iteration, and then it will keep on till the value of I becomes 10, or the condition that you provide over here. For now we have applied the condition as equals to 10, I less than equals to 10, so it will print up to 10. So we will get the multiplication table from 1 to 10 on the screen. Okay, so this is how multiplication table will be printed. Now let's check whether we are getting what we have explained there or not. So first is I, and then we need to place a string into, then we need to place the value of j, and then again we need equals to sign, right? And then we are going to get I into j. So here we are using the value of I and j during each iteration and printing the multiplication table by using these two nested for loops, right? So let's execute this and see whether we get the output or not. And see, we get the multiplication table up to 10, that is 10 into 10. It starts from 1 into 0 is equals to 0 to 1 into 10 is equals to 10, and then the j loop ends. J loop does not satisfy the condition because value of j becomes 11, and 11 less than equals to 10 is not true. And then inner loop ends. We again come to the outer loop where the value of I increases by 1 and it becomes 2, and then again the same process follows. From j will keep on iterating from 0 to 10, and we use that to print the multiplication table of 2 again, and then again j becomes 11 and it does not satisfy the condition, that means 11 less than equals to 10, and it again come out of this inner for loop, and again the value of I increases, and this will keep on till the outer for loop will not satisfy the condition that has been put over here. That means once I becomes 11, 11 less than equals to 10 will not satisfy, and then we will only get the multiplication table of 10 into 10 is equals to 100. If you increase this value, you will get the multiplication table of 11. If you increase this to 11, you will get the multiplication table of 11 as well. See, this time you get the multiplication table of 11 as well. So this is how you will apply this I to print the multiplication table up to where you want, and this is something which you can increase or decrease to make sure till where you want to print the multiplication table for that particular value. Suppose you just want to print up to 5, then you can decrease the value of j to 5, and you will see that you will only print each multiplication table till 5, 1 into 0 to 1 into 5, and then it becomes 2 into 0 to 2 into 5. So this is how you can use the logic to print up to where you want. But as it is traditional, we generally print up to 10, so let it be up to 10. And now there is one more thing which is required. We see that after 1 into 10, it immediately starts from 2 into 0 to 2 into 10. But we need to have some gap between this so that we can understand that, okay, table for 1 has completed and here the table for 2 starts. So what you can do is you can try to understand the logic. Now see, after 1 into 10, what is happening is you have this inner for loop which is ending, and once the inner for loop ends after 10 iteration, then what you can do is you can have one blank print statement which will give you the empty place. Means after each 10 iteration for j, you are giving one blank print statement, or you can also apply this one where you are not printing anything, that means blank string. So this will also work. If you don't give anything, that will also work. So let's execute and see. You are getting a space now after the multiplication table for one value completes. After the multiplication table for 1 completes, you are getting this gap. That means after each 10 iteration of j, once the inner for loop completes, so before exiting the inner for loop, you are printing an empty space, and that is why we are getting this empty space every time the value of j has iterated up to 10. So this is how we get multiplication table. Hope you have understood and now can apply the logic to print multiplication table for any combination combinations. So hope you have enjoyed this video tutorial. Please like and subscribe our channel to help us motivate. Thank you.